took that idea, sketched it in my little sketchbook, and when I got back to Apple, I realized that design with the engineers and the other designers on the team, and it resulted in the Slide to Unlock interface.
It was one of Freddy Anzures' key contributions to the design of the original iPhone.
I was really fortunate to be a part of a very small team that was responsible for the design of the iPhone. I think it's really important for somebody like me to make myself known to the community now. I've been pretty secretive. I think I'm at a point in my career where I think it's really important for the generation below me can see somebody that looks like them and can say that, well, if he can do it, I can do it.
Anzures recalls the inspiration for his lock screen came out of thin air.
I was visiting my brother in New York at the time, and I went on a Virgin America flight. When you lock the restroom door in the airplane, that was also another version of a lock, which was a horizontal left to right slide. The sound that it actually makes to kind of reinforce the fact that this thing is so familiar to you, even though it's a new technology, happened to come from this combination lock. This was the lock that I had on my locker from high school. I would lock it, and so I literally recorded that sound for the iPhone Slide to Unlock to lock sound, thinking that we would get Pixar to do a more high fidelity sound, but it ended up staying in the phone for a number of years.
Aside from Slide to Unlock, Anzures worked on the iPhone's visual voicemail feature, which transformed voicemail at that time.
What if you tap on the person's name, you hear them? What if it's just audio email?
After 13 years of design work at Apple, over 100 patents with Steve Jobs and the original iPhone design team, and creating signature features on the Macintosh, iPhone, iPod Touch, iPad, and Apple Watch.
You know, you have to kind of really enjoy the journey and the process to get there.
Anzures realizes his design work at Apple merely lays a foundation for what he feels is yet another passion of his, motivating and inspiring young Filipino Americans to not only dream big, but dream original.
I think a lot of the time our culture is known to be somewhat derivative of maybe other cultures that are more successful or a little bit more identifiable. Everybody is original if you're open to that. I could certainly just sit there and not do anything and then again be beholden to what's there. Or like Steve Jobs, if I were to use his example, well, you know, everything around you is made by someone else. You have the ability to change it. Okay, well, I'm gonna change it.
And that's it for this week on Tech Discovery. I'm Ginger Conejero.